Hey everyone, my name's Kelvin and welcome back to another watercolor tutorial for Procreate. So in today's video, we're gonna paint this illustration of Calcifer, who is another Studio Ghibli character from the movie Howl's Moving Castle. And that film is another one of my all-time favorites. And this character in particular is really funny because he's kind of a combination of a lot of things. Like his personality is he's sort of useless because he's just a fire. He can't go anywhere, like he's kind of helpless. But at the same time, he's just incredibly demanding and irritable, and just an all-around really funny character. So I've already got a watercolor paper texture already loaded into Procreate, and I'm using the Forester paper texture for this illustration. And for the brushes, I'm using the brushes that come with the regular watercolor brush kit. And as usual, I'll put links to everything I use in the description below. Now I have this sketch already loaded in here, and you guys can have that for free. It's just an image, and I've just placed it as the very top layer. And then I set the transparency mode to multiply. And I do that because I don't want it to just totally cover up everything that I'm painting, because from now on, we're gonna be painting on a layer underneath the paper texture, just like you normally would. So at first glance, this illustration looks like it has a lot of parts going on, but really there are just three parts. We've got the pan, we've got Calcifer, and we've got the log. And actually, Calcifer is in the very front. He's like the most foreground element in this illustration. So we're gonna start with him. So I'm gonna grab the abstract round brush from the regular watercolor kit. And what I'm gonna do is first, I'm gonna outline it in yellow, in red, and then I'm gonna fill in the center in yellow. Next, I'm gonna grab the water blender brush and at maybe a medium size, maybe around 20%, I'm just gonna blend where these kind of two different colors come together. Now that looks really good, but I wanna give the illusion that this is a little bit three-dimensional. So I'm gonna add shading. Even though he's a fire, I think shading looks kind of better on this illustration. So I'm gonna do the shading with the selection tool set to freehand. And I'll just select this side, and I'm gonna do add, and I'm gonna select just a little bit of the other side there. I'll feather both of those out quite a bit. Now when I go to my hue, saturation, and brightness adjustment for the layer, I can just darken it and then saturate it a little bit. And that's just gonna give the illusion that he's kind of like almost rounded or cylindrical shaped. Next, I'm gonna grab the eraser brush and I'm gonna set it to the fine liner pen. And at a really small size, I'm gonna cut the silhouette of Calcifer just following the sketch like this. Now, once it's been totally cut out, I need to remove the extra watercolor that's going beyond the edges here. And I like to do that with the selection tool, but you could always just use the eraser and just erase it by hand. But there's a trick here that'll kind of save you time. So I've got the selection tool and I'm gonna set it to automatic. And I'm gonna click and drag on the body of Calcifer and I'm gonna try to select everything. So I can adjust the threshold and I wanna set it so it totally fills out his silhouette. Next, I'm gonna go down here to invert. Now what it's done is we selected Calcifer, then when I clicked invert, it selected everything that was not Calcifer. Now when I open the layers panel, I can just tap on the layer with Calcifer and then click clear, and it will clear everything that we didn't select. And that's just a time-saving trick that's really good for quickly cleaning up the edges. Next, I'm gonna move on and do all the facial details on Calcifer, but I'm gonna do them on the same layer, and I'm gonna use basically the fine liner pen only, and I'm gonna do the eyes with just black and white. Then the mouth is gonna be a kind of medium red color. And sometimes when I do faces like this, I feel more comfortable to kind of turn it sideways. It just makes my strokes a little bit easier. So Calcifer is pretty much all done, and I can move on and do the pan next. I'm gonna do that on a different layer, so I'll make a new layer. And I think just to keep it simple for now, I'll turn off the layer with Calcifer on it. And I'm gonna do the pot with the abstract round brush, and I'm gonna set it to a sort of medium bluish gray color, pretty desaturated. And maybe at a medium size, around 30 or 40%, I'll just fill this out very, very roughly. So I managed to do the whole pot in one stroke, so it's very consistent. And just to add a little bit of interesting detail, I'm gonna go over it again and just add some shadows using a kind of second layer of strokes like this. There we go. And that just makes it a little bit more interesting. I don't recommend blending it, but you could if you really wanted to. Now, I've gone way beyond the edges of my sketch, so just like I did on the body of Calcifer, I'm going to use the eraser brush and just kind of clean it up where I went way beyond it. Next, I'm going to grab a lighter version of that same gray, and I'm going to grab the fineliner pen, and maybe about the same size I've been using, I'm just going to sort of outline the very edge of the pot. And that ended up a little bit too dark, so I think I'll make it a little bit lighter and then try again. There we go, that looks a lot better. Next, I'm going to fill out the egg, and this is really easy. I'm just going to use almost pure white, and then a kind of an orangey color for the yolk, and then I'll add some highlights. And all of this I'll do with the fineliner pen brush. So the egg looks good, and that was really easy to paint. Now the bacon is a little bit of a challenge, but still, I have a cool technique that'll make painting bacon super easy. So I've still got the fineliner pen selected, and for the color, I'm gonna start with a very light reddish white. I guess it would be like a pink color, and I'll just fill these in real quick. Next, I'm gonna grab a kind of medium red color, not too saturated though. And bacon, at least the way I like to paint bacon, it has a kind of gradient to it. So on one side, I'll add a kind of a bold red line. Then I'm gonna go over it again and add some lines that kind of diverge off of that original line. Then as a finishing touch for this color, I'll just add a few kind of isolated segments, just kind of randomly around there. There we go. Next, I'm gonna grab a, you know, it's somewhere between that first color and this redder color, maybe somewhere in here, I think. And I'm gonna do some longer strokes like this, not broken up or anything, kind of streaky. There we go. And then to finish this up, I'm gonna grab a very, very light color, even lighter than that first color we selected, maybe even almost pure white. And I'm just gonna outline this in a couple of areas. And just in case you want to keep going and add more detail, you can always add some kind of perpendicular lines, breaking up the stringy part. So there we go, that looks really nice. Now the pan here is almost done, but it does look a little bit flat. And this is optional, but I do kind of recommend adding a little bit of shading to this. So first I'll add a highlight using the freehand selection tool. And I'll just make a selection up here, and I'll feather that one out quite a bit. Then I'll go to hue, saturation, and brightness for the layer, and I'll just raise the brightness. There we go. Next, I want to add a shadow. So on the bottom of the pot, I'll make another freehand selection, just like that. I'll feather it out. And this one, I'm going to do the same thing, except I'll darken it this time. So next, I'm going to turn Calcifer back on so we can see him. And you can see right away we have a little bit of a transparency issue, but there's a really easy way to solve this. So the pot is above Calcifer, but remember Calcifer is basically the most foreground element. So I'm gonna drag the pot underneath him, and we still can see the pot kind of coming through there. So the reason is because these brushes, these watercolor brushes, have a transparent effect, and we can block that out. So this is a trick I've used before, but it's really easy. We're just gonna create a white background that fits behind Calcifer and blocks out the pot. So I'm gonna duplicate Calcifer. And here's the copy at the top. I'll just turn that off for now. I'm gonna select the bottom one. I'm gonna go to hue, saturation, and brightness. And I'm gonna max out the brightness. And it looks like he's disappeared. But if you check the layers panel, you can see he's still there. He's just been turned pure white. And I'm gonna make two or three copies of him. I think maybe two copies is enough. You don't wanna make too many copies. So here I've got two copies of white Calcifer. I'll turn on the original one. And now you can see it's totally blocking off the pan. That's because there are two white versions of him between the pan, between him and the pan. So now I'll merge all three together just to keep this a little bit easier to manage. So there we go, we've solved the transparency issue and he exactly covers up the pan. Next, I'm going to move on and do the log, and this one is probably the easiest part of this whole illustration. So I'll make a new layer, and now I'm going to put it behind Calcifer. I'm going to select kind of a brownish color, then I'm going to quickly fill it out using the abstract round brush. And after that first kind of initial layer of color, I'll go over it again with a slightly darker brown, just to make the shading on this a little bit more complex. Then to bring out the ends of the logs, because the bark is usually darker, I want the ends to be lighter. I'm going to select a very, very light brown and just kind of block those out a little bit. Now everywhere that Calcifer is touching, I want the log to look like it's kind of burning. So I'm going to select a very, very dark brown, almost black, and I'll just do these kind of horizontal strokes kind of all along that boundary. Next, I'm going to grab almost black, maybe this really, really dark gray color. And I'm going to do this another layer of these kind of horizontal lines, but a little bit more sparingly, just to make it look like it's really burning in these areas. Next, I'm going to grab the water blender, and I'm going to very lightly blend this. I like the hard edges, so I'm going to try not to blend all of them out. And to finish up this log, I'm going to go over it with the eraser, just like we did before, and just clean it up wherever it goes way beyond the pencil lines. So this one is almost done. I'm just gonna turn off the pencil sketch. We don't need it anymore. And I'm gonna look for any mistakes that I might have made. Now right away I can see there's this kind of white space between the Calcifer and the pan. So what I'll do is I'll just lower the pan. So I'm gonna select that layer, grab the arrow tool, and just nudge it down a little bit. There we go. And all this looks really good. I think next I'll just finish it up and do the outline. So I'm gonna make a new layer for that. And I'll place it above everything, even above Calcifer. And I'm gonna use pure black and the fine liner pen. And at a pretty small size, maybe around 10%, I'm just gonna add a couple of outlines wherever I think it needs a little bit of help with the contrast. Now, I don't wanna get too carried away with the outline. So it's important to kind of judge whether you really need to add an outline in that area. Because at least for me, I feel like if I see too many outlines, it doesn't look quite right. So I'll just do my best to add these in wherever I think they look good. After that, I'm going to open up the layers panel, and here's the layer with all the outlines. I'm going to set the transparency mode to multiply, then lower it to zero. Then I'm going to slowly raise it back up just until I feel like the outlines are dark enough, but not kind of pure black. And there we go. This one is all done. And here's what it looks like when I print it out. So I know the process in this video is a little bit long, but I tried to keep it as simple as I can. Most of my illustrations are just like single element illustrations, and I wanted to take the time to show you this one and kind of how I would tie together three distinct different elements in a little scene. I think the main tricky part is the white background trick that we did with Calcifer to kind of block out the transparency issue we had with the pot. Now, if that's confusing, I totally understand. Maybe I can recommend to watch that part again. And maybe give it a try yourself, because it's a super useful technique for painting more complicated illustrations like this. And if you've made it this far, I'm totally grateful for your time, for watching this. I'd love to know what you think of these videos, and if you have any ideas for future videos. Of course, you can like this video, and that will really help the channel. You can also subscribe if you haven't already. And if you have any ideas, please leave a comment below, because I read pretty much every single comment. I'm still kind of a small channel, so it's easy for me to keep up with it all. And that pretty much wraps it up. But as always, thank you so much for your support. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.